there. Welcome back to Read Me a Story. Today we have a special guest joining us at the Oxford Police Department. We're going to show you their fun cars and all of the lights that come along with it. Let's start with our first story, Police Officer on Patrol, and it's by Kirsten Hamilton. Uniform, badge, radio. Police officer getting ready to go. Squad report, Sergeant Santoli, people need help. Let's rock and roll. A broken light may cause a crash. Who can help? Well, who is fast? Officer Mike on traffic patrol. Uniform, badge, radio. Officer responding, go Mike, go. Situation under control. When people need help, we rock and roll. This little boy can't find his mom. Uh-oh, he needs help. Who will come? Officer Jan on mounted patrol. Uniform, badge, radio. Officer responding, go Jan, go. Situation under control. When people need help, we rock and roll. Robbers robbing Mulgrave. Who will help? Who is brave? Officer Carl on crime patrol. Uniform, badge, radio. Officer responding, go Carl, go. Situation under control. When people need help, we rock and roll. Uniform, badge, radio. If you need help, they're on patrol. The end. Stay tuned. We'll get ready for our second story.
Emergency police, ambulance, or fire?
Hello?
Hi, you have 911. How can I help you?
Hello?
Hi, who's this? Oh, how are you today?
Good.
Yeah? How old are you?
5.
You're 5, eh? Is mom or dad around? Can I talk to one of them?
Who are you?
Well, you called me. What number did you dial?
I don't know.
You dialed 911, eh? Did you want to see if it actually worked?
I don't remember what 911 they did.
Yeah, 911 is for emergencies. It's for the ambulance or if you need a police officer or if there's a fire and you need a firefighter. Didn't they teach you that in school about 911 that you call if somebody needs help?
Yeah.
Okay, so does somebody need help today or were you just testing it out?
Just testing.
Just testing, eh? Well, I'm here.
Hello, we are not available now. Please leave your name and phone number after the beep.
Hi, this is Toronto Police Service calling. Called 911. We just wanted to make sure everything was okay there. The officers will be attending your home. If you have no emergency, please call us back. Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Are you the mom or
yes,
your brother?
I'm the mom.
Oh, okay. He had called 911.
Oh,
he wanted to make sure we were really here.
I am so
apparently
sorry.
He learned about us in school recently.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
Everything's okay though,
fine.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Take it, take it, take it, take it.
And we're ready for our second story. Today it is Police Officers by Jacqueline Corman. An important job. A police officer has an important job. A police officer helps people. A police officer helps people in trouble. A police officer keeps people safe. Police gear. Police officers wear badges and special uniforms. They use radios to talk to each other. A safe neighborhood. Police officers stop people who break the law, and they help keep your neighborhood safe. Some police officers ride in police cars. Some ride on motorcycles. Sometimes police officers direct traffic. They give tickets to drivers who drive too fast. Sometimes police officers visit schools. They talk about how to stay safe. If you are ever lost or you need help, a police officer can help you. Would you like to be a police officer one day? The end. Stay tuned after this break. We'll be back.
Think buying fake products is harmless? Think again. Think fake cosmetics are tested and safe? Think again. Think that medicine you can buy off social media is high quality? Think again. Counterfeits are made in unsafe conditions, potentially using hazardous and even lethal ingredients that could harm you and others. Each year, billions of dollars worth of counterfeit products are sold in the U.S. I smell big crime. Think about it. If you don't know where the products came from, how could you know where the money goes? You're smart. Buy smart. Go for real.
Medicaid and CHIP offer free or low-cost health coverage for kids and teens. These programs cover doctor's appointments, hospital visits, prescriptions, shots, and more. As parents, we get peace of mind knowing that our children are covered if they are sick or get injured. You may now be eligible for Medicaid, too, even if you've applied in the past. Enrollment is always open. Visit InsureKidsNow.gov or call 1-877-KIDS-NOW. Paid for by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Just think, what if we didn't have local TV and radio? Where would I go for local sports, local politics, a mayor, city council, stuff that affects me every day? How about health? Who's covering things that endanger my family? I need to know now, as it happens, from sources I trust, people in my community. No agenda, no bias like you find on cable and social media, just facts. For news I can trust, I stay local. Support your local station. Text TV to 52886 today.
Welcome to Oxford Community Television. We are proud that our four communities continue to choose local programming, local news, sports, community issues, familiar faces, celebrations, and commitment to each other. Welcome to Oxford Community Television.
Hi, everybody. My name is Chief Mike Solwold with the Oxford Police Department. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about, all the cool stuff that we have in our police car that we use every day. We have computers, we have radar units, we have, lights and sirens, all that cool stuff. So I'm just going to kind of point some things out as we go along as far as what we use every day. Like the computer in the car. Computer in the car helps us be able to find out if people are driving with driver's licenses that should be driving around that are valid. It helps us find addresses for people that we need to go help and find. It also helps us print out tickets for people that have maybe speeded or have been speeding or running stop signs or committing traffic violations. The radar that I mentioned is actually a tool that we use to find out how fast somebody is going on the road. So if they're going over the speed limit, then that's when we can write them a ticket if they're going over the speed limit. And we do that so we can keep people safe. So just like you guys in school have all your tools, you got your pencils, your pens, your paper and all that stuff. These are all the tools that we use for the police. And going back to the lights and sirens, well, we have those because if we have to get somewhere fast, we need everybody to get out of our way safely so we can get to that scene and get to where we need to get to fast so we can help somebody. That's the lights and sirens. And I'm already mentioned what we do with the computer. I mentioned what we do with the radar to see if somebody's speeding or committing any kind of traffic violation so we can keep people safe. That's why we do that. We also have in our cars video cameras. So not only do we wear what's called body cams on our uniforms, we also have cameras inside the car so we can videotape what's happening in front of us. So when we pull up onto a traffic stop, we can see everything in front of us, the car, the license plate, and the people in front of us. Or coming up onto an accident scene, we can have a video of the accident scene and the damage that's in front of us. If not, then we can use the body cam that we have on our uniforms as well. So just to go back over again with what we do, we get our police car, we check and make sure everything works. We turn on the lights and sirens, we open up our laptop computer, we make sure that that works. We turn on our radar, make sure our radar is working so we can see how fast people are going. We make sure that our cameras are working. And then, I don't know if you heard that, but that's a radio. That's another officer talking. We have radios in our cars just like we keep on our uniform belts. So that way we can communicate with each other. So if my other officer needs help when he's working, I can go over to where he's at and help him if he needs it. Or he can come help me if I need it. And the other cool thing is if I can't tell him where I'm at, what's cool is he can track me without that by satellite, which is really cool. So he can come find me even if I can't tell him where I'm at, which is really neat. So that means keeps me safe and keeps everybody else safe. So it's kind of like a GPS in your car if you want to, you know, navigate or try to find somewhere, which is really cool. Then you got to make sure that, you know, everything is working in your car so you're safe and everybody else is safe on the road, just like everybody should do when they get in their car. Turn signals work, your headlights work, your brake lights work, all that good stuff. And make sure you got a full tank of gas, because when you got to go, you got to go, and you got to get there and help whoever you got to help. So everybody stay safe out there. If you see me out and about, come and say hi. Thanks, guys. everybody. Hey, I am Chief Mike with the Oxford Police Department, and I get the cool job to read to you today about big heroes. And I'm a big fan of big heroes, whether it's Marvel or DC Comics. Batman is my favorite. I kind of got, you know, Batman kind of all over the place, and he's really cool. Batman, I think, is the best superhero because he doesn't have special powers, but he has what he has on him that he relies on, like the police officer. So, get it? All right, so anyway, now that we've learned that, we're going to move on to the big heroes, which has got Superman, Batman, Green Lantern, and all these cool guys in here. And Batman, which is kind of cool, he kind of gets everybody going and gets all the superheroes together and says, hey, we got to make sure that we save the day and we got to find out what's going on and let's work together and get this done. Like the police do, police and firefighters, we get together and we help take care of whatever the situation is to keep everybody safe. So I'm excited to read this book called Big Heroes. So, turning the page, we got all the big heroes on here. We've got, after the Super Friends saved Metropolis, once again, the city thanked them with a loud cheer. But one person was not cheering. What? Lex Luthor? My latest invention will bring those Super Friends down to size. The villain grumbled, in his secret laboratory, I am going to zap them with my... What? Gonna turn the page. And Shrink Ray! Now nothing will stop me from taking over Metropolis, Lex shouted. The colossal criminal took a deep breath and blew the shrunken Super Friends away. We're the size of ants, Batman said. But we can still stop Lex, Superman declared. Only the Flash noticed the dark shadow looming over their heads. This is crazy. Suddenly, an enormous praying mantis grabbed Superman in its spiky claws. Imagine a giant praying mantis. How scary is that? The Super Friends began to battle the insect. We need a little help with one Mother Nature's other creatures, Batman said. See, here we go, Batman. He's coming up with an idea. He threw himself against the spider's web, causing the silky strands to vibrate. Now, see, that'd be kind of scary. I got this thing about spiders. They're kind of scary, so... That's pretty brave of Batman to throw himself against a web. A hairy spider scurried down the web and attacked the praying mantis. As the two creepy crawlies clashed, the Super Friends dashed away. Where are you guys going? Unfortunately, the Flash ran right into a hungry Venus flytrap. Oh my God, those are those plants with those big mouths. The plant's prickly jaws snapped shut. Trapping the Flash. I'm like, what? Superman used his incredible strength to open the plant's thorny mouth. Batman swung in on his bat rope to free the Flash. Thanks, the Flash said. For a second, I thought I was going to be fast food. What? Fast food. Then it started to rain. Green Lantern and the Aquaman were swept away in the trickle of water, which was like a raging river to the tiny heroes. As Aquaman tumbled under the water, he called out to a nearby turtle. It gave him a ride to solid ground. Imagine riding on a turtle? That's crazy. The other Super Friends dodged raindrops as they raced to catch up with Aquaman. Green Lantern created a submarine with his power ring to escape the rough water. Let's go get Lex Luthor, Superman said. As all the Super Friends arrive safely on the scene. Here we go. See, everybody's getting together. We're going to take care of some business. The shrunken heroes dodge speeding cars, barking dogs, sticky fingers, and big boots until they found Lex. I'm the king of Metropolis, Lex said. Yeah, we'll see about that, huh? Lex didn't notice a hornet's nest hanging over his head, but the Super Friends did. Superman used his heat vision to cut the nest loose. And that's what I'm talking about. X-ray vision. Can you imagine having X-ray vision? That'd be awesome. It fell right into Lex's lap. Hundreds of angry hornets started to sting him. Whoa. At super speed, the Flash ran to the shrink ray and switched the controls to reverse. Wow. Green Lantern used his power ring to activate the shrink ray. The super friends began to grow bigger and bigger. Bigger, Superman grabbed Lex. The people in Metropolis were saved. Everyone cheered. Foiled again, Lex Batman said, and this time by a bunch of tiny hornets. It just goes to show you, Superman said, that heroes will always save the day no matter what size they are. That's what I'm talking about. That's a great story. Don't mess with my big hero super friends. That's what I'm saying. And hey, thanks for listening today. It's been an honor to talk to you guys about Super Friends. And thank you for letting me read to this to you today. And being a big Batman fan, we say, hey, you guys be safe out there. Take care. Bye, guys.
I know kids worry about a lot of things. Getting enough food to eat shouldn't be one of them. Through a nationwide network of food banks, Feeding America serves virtually every community in the United States. See how you can help your community. Visit feedingamerica.org.
I'm Natalie Moser. I'm a volunteer here at Canine Stray Rescue, and this playful pup is Slush. Slush is about 2 years old, about 60 pounds. He's a big guy. He is a husky mix, as you can see. He is shedding quite a bit right now, which means get the brush ready. He's very playful and goofy, very energetic. Very, very intelligent, so we need an adopter that's experienced with this breed so that they can really engage his mind the way it needs to be engaged. He is good with other dogs, but a meet and greet is required because he can be a lot of energy for other dogs. No aggression or anything like that out of him with other dogs. He loves treat puzzles and anything that uses his brain because he is incredibly intelligent. He's described as goofy, fun-spirited. He's just a really all-around great, a great dog. We have him in the play area, and especially on those chillier days, it can get a little slippery, and so he slips and slides, but it doesn't stop him at all. He is just a big goof with beautiful blue eyes and a kind of a red-tinted fur, which I'm told is not super common. We also ask, because of his energy level and he still jumps and needs some manners, that kids in the home be at least 13 years old. He needs a lot of energy. He's just a lot of energy for the younger kids. If you have a teenager who likes to run, this guy would be a great, great fit for you. He's just a big baby. Are you just a big playful baby? Is that what you are? Is that what you are? He's affectionate. He's sweet. He's connecting with people. He's just what you would picture the stereotypical dog to be, where he's just a big, goofy, lovable ball of hair. What I tell people is, yes, it's important to exercise your dog, but it's even more, if not just as important, to exercise the mind. If you think about how exhausted you were when you were in high school, you come home, you know, they're when you engage their minds and you do that training, that wears them out just too much. If you're interested in Slush or any of our other adoptable dogs, fill out an application at caninestray.com or come by during any of our open hours.
We're happy you're back, and we're ready for our very last story today. I hope you've had fun with me at the Oxford Police Station. Our last story is Heroes to the Rescue, and it's by Esther Ripley. Welcome to the city. The streets of Lego City are busy with cars, trucks, bikes, and people. The emergency services are always on patrol to help any citizens who are in trouble.
A police car controls the traffic in the main square. Firefighters rush to the scene of a fire. Their fire engines have all the equipment that they need to put out the blaze. Police. Lego City is kept safe by its brave police force. When a citizen is lost or in trouble, the police officers on the streets are there to help us. The police keep the traffic moving and catch crooks. They have high-speed cars and motorcycles to get them to the scene of an accident or a robbery. And this says Lego City's most wanted: robber, graffitiist, vandal, shoplifter, pickpocket, jewel thief. Prison Island. The crooks who make trouble in Lego City are locked up in cells on Prison Island. Prison Island is a fortress with bars on the windows, powerful searchlights. The police officers keep watch day and night. The crooks are pretending to rest in their cells, but uh-oh, they have a sneaky plan to escape from prison. High security on Prison Island. They have a helicopter and a rocket on the island and a satellite dish. And there's the basement pipe. Uh-oh, I wonder what might happen there. And security cameras. Escape. Sound the alarm. The crooks have escaped from their cells on Prison Island. Oh, no. Two prisoners are speeding away in an inflatable boat. Look up at the sky. Two more crooks are floating away in a hot air balloon. The guard calls for help to catch the sneaky crooks. Crooks hideout. The crooks have built a secret hideout on a rock in the middle of the ocean. They have lots of tools and stolen objects. Uh-oh, including a safe full of money. The crooks think no one will find them here. They hope the police do not come looking for them. Inside their hideout, they can relax. They even have taken a coffee machine so they can make themselves hot drinks. The police are on the lookout for the escaped prisoners. Police cars race through the city streets. Police look for clues about where the crooks are hiding. Whirring across the sky, the police helicopter has a bird's eye view of the city and of the ocean. The pilot uses his radio to tell the other officers where the crooks might be hiding. I spy a crook. Watch out, here come the police. Captured! The officers are on the police boat. They use their satellite dish to find the crook's lair. There's nowhere for the crooks to hide. A police officer arrests the crooks. He puts handcuffs on one prisoner and marches the pair into a boat. The police boat captain takes them all back to Prison Island. The end. Thank you for joining us today, learning a lot about our heroes. And we're at the Oxford Police Station. Anytime you see them, make sure you wave and say hi. They would love to wave back. Have a great day, and we'll see you next time.